Can we talk for a second about Media Cache? And if you are a Premiere Pro or After Effects user, you're probably building up a storage of unnecessary files on your computer, and if you got rid of them, you could free up a bunch of space. Now, to explain this, let me say I'm metaphorically a computer. Now, it could be Windows or Mac, but the main concept that I want to get across here is that anytime you open up Adobe After Effects or Premiere Pro and you start importing footage, it's gonna create these preview render files or media cache, and these pre-rendered files help with playback while you're editing your project. Now you can imagine that these files are going to build up over time. And after you're done with these projects, they're basically unnecessary. The good thing is Adobe has made it easy for you to delete your unnecessary media cache fast in Premiere Pro and After Effects, thus giving you so much more storage on your computer. You could smash that like button right about now, and let's go ahead and show you how to delete your media cache on the computer. This will work whether you are on Windows or Mac. I'm gonna go to Premiere Pro, Preferences, Media Cache. And in this panel, all we have to do is remove media cache files. I'm gonna hit delete. You can delete unused media cache files, or you could delete all media cache files from the system. It explains to you here that deleting unused media cache files removes the files that were created from the source media that can no longer be found, or deleting all media cache files deletes all cache files from the current location. Deleted cache files will be recreated automatically whenever source media requires them. To use this option, if you already have a project open, you're gonna have to restart Premiere, and before you open any project, you're gonna have to come back to this screen and hit delete all media cache files from the system, and you can hit okay. For this, I'm gonna do delete all media cache files because I don't have a project open, and now I'm cleaning all of my media database. While that's going, there's a couple more important concepts about media cache that you may wanna know about when it comes to deleting all of these files. The first would be that if you didn't want to delete your cache files through the program itself, you could do it manually by going to these spots on a Mac or Windows computer. Now, besides clearing up some space on your computer, deleting your media cache is a great way to solve a lot of the problems or errors that will come up in Premiere Pro or After Effects. That's because sometimes when you're editing in these softwares, something weird may happen to one of those preview media cache files and it will get corrupt. So by doing this process, you actually alleviate some of those errors that you get in Premiere Pro and After Effects. Another thing to keep in mind is for this example, I'm deleting all of my media cache files. That includes the current projects that I'm working on. So if you have a huge project, just be conscious that it's going to take time to rewrite all those files when you reopen that project in Premiere Pro. So if you can save this task for overnight, that might be the best. But obviously, if you're troubleshooting a problem, then go ahead and do what you need to do. Now let's see how much space we saved. I had 689 gigabytes available before, and now I have 694. Next, we're going to do this for After Effects. So again, before I really open any projects, I'm going to go up to After Effects, Preferences, Media and Disk Cache. In the preferences window, here's where you can set the maximum cache size to whatever disk that After Effects is writing to. And it even tells you that for improved performance, you should choose a disk cache folder that's on a fast hard drive or SSD separate from where you're putting your footage. I'm gonna hit empty disk cache. Are you sure you wanna delete all files? And look at this, my disk cache is 19.5 gigabytes. Hit okay, boom, and it's gone. Awesome. And then your conformed media cache. I'm going to do clean database and cache, and that just happened in the matter of a couple seconds. So from starting out with only 689 gigabytes available, now I have 715 gigabytes available. Leave a like on the video if that's going to save you some space on your computer. If you like this kind of content, hit that subscribe button. Until next episode, I hope you're out there living a life of abundance.